The Star Wars franchise has found itself in a bit of a conundrum. It is late 2018, 4 films into the revamp of the property, and you would think this would be the height of Star Wars fandom. But it isn't. Go back in time to when The Force Awakens was getting hyped up, and most people would say they could not wait to be at this point, to have 4 new Star Wars movies released, and the promise of more on the way. Hell, I was one of them. But we find ourselves here, late 2018, and it almost feels as if no one cares anymore, like the light has burnt out. There are many different factors as to why this has happened, but many would put the blame on the last 2 films released, The Last Jedi and Solo, A Star Wars Story. One of these films split the fans down the middle harder than I have ever seen, and the other has been forgotten about almost immediately. But to say that this is because of those movies specifically would be dangerously ignorant. Now I do think that The Last Jedi is a part of this too, but that film is a whole different can of worms that I am not willing to get into right now. So today, I'm going to be taking a second look into Solo. After rewatching this film again, I believe that fans are way too harsh on everything about it. Is it perfect? No. But is it a bad film? That, I'm not too sure about anymore. Upon release, I was a person who was adamantly against everything about this movie. I thought the whole idea was pointless, and because of that, my opinion was biased. This left me feeling sour about the project as a whole, and leaving the theater after the first viewing, I hated it. I now see that my harsh opinion was unnecessary and probably misplaced. There's nothing wrong with this movie at all, and I believe fans are angry at it for all the wrong reasons. This film, it is just a movie, and I think that this is its biggest problem. See, Star Wars as a whole is having a battle with itself. The brand is hurting itself in the process of trying to expand. After years of lying dormant after the prequels, fans sat and waited, and waited, and waited, until the very idea of a Star Wars story was the greatest thing they could ever think of. And because of this, there is nothing that Disney could create to satisfy the people. It almost seems as if the new films were doomed from the start. From the beginning, fans were quite unsure about the idea of a Han Solo film. No one could agree on whether it would be a better idea to make it an origin or to go with just a random adventure. I believe that the random story of Han could have worked better, almost as a space Indiana Jones, but that's beside the point. What is important is that no matter what creatives did with this property, people would have been angry. I'm sure there are hundreds, probably thousands of people that think my idea is the dumbest thing they have ever heard. There was zero chance of Disney pleasing everyone. No matter what Lord and Miller did with the film, people would have been mad. No matter what Ron Howard did with the film, people would have been mad. There is no outcome where there is not a sector of Star Wars fans that end up getting angry. And that is this film's biggest problem. Alden Ehrenreich is good as Han. All the other actors are good in their roles. The story is fun and upbeat, and there are some genuinely good moments throughout.
You look great!
Chewie, get in! All hell bend it.
But even if Ehrenreich came out with a performance so spot on to the original, there would still be uproar about something else. Even if this film was a complete masterpiece, there would still be arguments saying, that's not my Han. First, I want to talk about what this film did absolutely correct. I want to say, and I understand this may not be the most popular opinion out there, but Han and Chewie's relationship in this film is exactly what I always pictured. They feel like 2 completely different people who found themselves in an awful situation, but got out of it together. This feels believable as to why they would stick together for all the years after this film. It makes sense that Chewie would stay by Han's side through everything. While it can come across as goofy at times,
you couldn't have done this maybe like one at a time?
It works, and that is what is important. Emilia Clarke's character, while at times coming across as a bit stale, is definitely a welcome addition to this film, and after rewatching it, I appreciate the effort from the writers to make her character someone with a purpose, not just a love interest for Han to bounce off of. The relationship between her and the movie's villain is intriguing, and Paul Bettany is genuinely frightening at times as the opponent to Emilia Clarke. And, I want to make this very clear, Bettany's character is not Han's villain in this movie. They are not adversaries, and although they find themselves in conflict at times, Bettany is Emilia Clarke's villain. The true villain to Han's story is Beckett. Beckett turns Han into the smuggler we find at the beginning of Star Wars. This film shows that Beckett is Han's antithesis, and I believe that this is something that works very well for the story. What we got is what we were given. And I don't think there's anything wrong with this. I believe that in 2018, it is okay for some films to be just movies for the fans. I think it is okay that a film is mostly tailored around fan service, because I mean, in all honesty, isn't that what these films are all about? Pleasing the fans? It seems about time for people that love Star Wars to take a step back and really open their eyes to what they are criticizing so much. As the fans, we should calm ourselves down and allow the creators to do what they are being paid to do. Create. For those who state that this is not your Han, I believe you are absolutely correct. But this is not your Han either. And this is not your Luke. It's his. Han never belonged to you, and you can like it or not, but in reality, whatever it is the creatives create, it belongs to them. So while you may not agree with this version of the character, and yes, he may not be your Han, he never was yours in the first place.